Hello everyone, welcome to class 11th and this is your very first lecture of economics. As I have sent you the PDF of economics syllabus, hopefully you all have seen that PDF, and in that PDF you might have seen that in economics we are going to study two books. First is Statistics for Economics, second is Microeconomics. So today we are going to start our second book, Microeconomics. And the first chapter of that book is Economics and Economy. Firstly, starting with the meaning of economics. What does the meaning of economics? That means economics means optimum utilization of scarce or limited resources among its different alternative availables. That means what does economics stands for? Optimal, that means proper planned utilization of scarce resources, scarce also called as a limited resources, among its different available alternatives. To make the meaning more simpler, we can divide this meaning into three subparts. That is, economic is a proper utilization. For what proper utilization? Proper utilization of scarce resources. Why we have to utilize the scarce resources properly? Because that scarce resources are having different alternative uses. In simple, we can say that ki jo hamare limited resources hain, usse ek proper planned way se utilize karna hai. क्यों? क्योंकि हमारे जो लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज हैं उनके डिफरेंट ऑल्टरनेटिव्स भी अवेलेबल हैं जिसमें हम उनको क्या कर सकते हैं, यूज़ कर सकते हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल, इनकम, वाटर, कैपिटल, कोल माइंस, ऑयल वेल्स एंड मैनी अदर रिसोर्सेज आर देयर. फर्स्टली इफ वी टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ अ वाटर, वाटर को हम किन किन पर्पज़ के लिए यूज़ कर सकते हैं? फॉर ब्रशिंग, फॉर वॉशिंग क्लोथ, for cooking, for bathing, right? And many other alternatives are there, right? Where we can use the water. So, इसमें से हमें पहले क्या करना है? Priority basis पे decide करना है कि water को, जो एक हमारे पास एक limited resource है, हमें उसे किस first priority base पे use करना है? क्या हमें उसे cooking purposes के लिए use करना है? या brushing के लिए use करना है? या clothing के लिए use करना है? सो इन प्रॉब्लम्स का सोल्यूशन हमें कौन देता है? इकोनॉमिक्स देती है. ओके, सो फर्दर यू कैन सी इन द फ्लो चार्ट दैट की ह्यूमन वॉन्ट्स आर अनलिमिटेड, राइट? बट टू फुलफिल द ह्यूमन वॉन्ट द रिसोर्स वी हैव टेकन वन रिसोर्स दैट इज इनकम. दैट इज, इनकम इज लिमिटेड एंड प्लस इट हैज़ मैनी ऑल्टरनेटिव यूजेज एज वेल, राइट? विच गिव राइज टू वन मोर प्रॉब्लम दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ए प्रॉब्लम ऑफ चॉइस. So to solve that problem of choice, which tool we use? We use economics as the tool to solve the problem of choice. So what does problem of choice stands for? Problem of choice means when the limited resources are having alternative uses. For example, income. Income can be used for multiple purposes. That means for paying rent, for paying tuition fees, for buying grocery, for buying mobile phones, for paying electricity bill, and many other purposes are there for which we can use our income source. We know that ki our income is a limited resource, right? For example, we are having monthly income of rupees 10,000. And now the problem is that ki how we want to utilize that 10,000 among its different available alternatives. So these are the different available alternatives: paying rent, tuition fees, buying grocery, mobile phone, electricity bill payment, right? So what we will do, firstly we will, according to our priority base, we will rank these alternatives. That means firstly we want to buy the grocery, then we want to pay the electricity bill, then we want to pay the rent, then tuition fees, then for the mobile phone and any other alternatives. That means firstly we will use this limited income to pay our electricity bill, then to buy our grocery, then to pay the rent, then to tuition fee, etc. Accordingly, we will utilize this limited resource. So coming to the next topic, that is the types of economics. So there are two types of economics. One is microeconomics, other is macroeconomics. Firstly, starting with the microeconomics, what does microeconomics stands for? It is the combination of two words. One is micro, other economics. Right? We can also call say that ki economics is the study of the economic issues. That means economic issues prevailing at the small level and how to solve those issues and how to use those resources in an optimal manner. So we can say that ki microeconomics means to study economic issues at small or individual level. Individual level, like a individual consumer is there, an individual producer is there, an individual market we have to study. Right? So further, the components of microeconomics, there are three components of microeconomics. First is theory of consumer equilibrium, theory of producer equilibrium, and theory of prices there. So we will study this one by one. Firstly, the theory of consumer equilibrium. What does theory of consumer equilibrium stands for? Firstly, the word consumer. What is consumer stands for? A consumer is a person who consumes the commodity. That means we, everyone, are the consumers, right? If we are going to a pen shop and we will buy one pen, that means we are the consumer. Consumer of which good? Consumer of the pen. Right. So what does equilibrium stands for? Equilibrium stands for a balancing situation, a satisfactory situation on which our satisfaction level is maximum. So what does consumer equilibrium stands for? In this theory, we will analyze or we will study that how a consumer allocate his income to different uses so that he can maximize his level of satisfaction. Obviously, if we take our own example, we are the consumer, and which thing we need to buy a product? We need money. And from where we get the money? From our income sources. So income factor we use to buy different commodities. So here in this theory, we will study that how consumer will use this limited income factor to buy different commodities so that the level of satisfaction a consumer is deriving by buying the different commodities can be the maximum to maximum which he can derive. Right. Next is theory of producer equilibrium. Again, the term producer. Who is a producer? Producer is the one who produces the good. Right. So in this theory, we will decide, we will study that a producer will produce which type of product and in which quantity he will produce that product so that the cost factor can be minimized and the profit factor can be maximized. Right. So if we are taking our own example again, if now we are taking ourselves as the producer. So as a producer, what will be our motive? Our motive will be to increase the profit. How we can increase the profit? By minimizing the cost factor and by increasing the revenue factor. Because profit can be maximized only if the revenue income is more than the cost factor. So we will try to sell more of the product and to minimize the cost factor so that the profit can be maximized. Next is theory of price. In this theory of price, we will study that ki how the market forces of demand and supply determines the price of a good. It is not the producer every time that who decides the price of the product. Right, it is the market forces. That means how much the consumer is demanding and how much the producer is willing to supply in the market. And where the individual demand is equals to the individual supply, there starts the price of the commodity. There starts the equilibrium in the market where equilibrium price established. So coming to the next topic, that is the macroeconomics. So what does macroeconomics stands for? It is again a combination of two words. Firstly, macro and economics. Right? Macro has been taken from the Greek word makro, M-A-K-R-O. Right? Macro means large. This is opposite of microeconomics. In microeconomics, we are studying the individual level problems. In this, we are studying the problems by taking one nation as a whole, by taking one economy as a whole. That means in whole of the economy, how we have to utilize our scarce resources among its different possible alternatives. So macroeconomics deals with issues of an economy as a whole. For example, inflation, deflation, unemployment level, output level, income level in the economy. So there exist three components of microeconomics, that is theory related to equilibrium in the economy, theory related to disequilibrium in the economy, theory related to correction of disequilibrium in the economy. So we are going to study this one by one. Firstly, theory related to equilibrium in the economy. Again, the word equilibrium. Equilibrium means a balancing situation in the economy, right? In the microeconomics, we have studied individual demand. That means demand by one consumer and individual supply, demand by one producer is there. But in this, we are going to study economy as a whole. We are going to study the aggregate factor. That means there exists number of consumer in the economy. And the demand of number of consumers is called as the aggregate demand. And the supply of number of producers in the economy is called as the aggregate supply of the economy. So, what does theory related to equilibrium in the economy stands for? In this theory, we will study that ki how the balance situation structs in the economy. Balancing situation, that means at which point aggregate demand is equals to the aggregate supply in the economy. Second is theory related to disequilibrium in the economy. Disequilibrium, that means disbalancing situation. As you can see in the flowchart, that means in the first point we have studied that AD is equals to AS, right? Agar AD AS ki equal nahi hai, to uski opposite situation kya ho sakti hai? That AD is not equal to AS, right? AD is not equal to AS, uske do consequences ho sakte hain, whether it can be AD is greater than AS or it can be AD is less than AS. Right, when AD is greater than AS, that means it is showing ki that aggregate demand is greater than the aggregate supply. That means in this situation that ki excess demand exists in the economy. Excess of demand is there over the supply. That means excess demand exists in the economy, and due to that inflationary gap is there in the economy, and due to that it leads to inflation in the economy. Inflation means that means increase in the general price level in the economy. And on the opposite side, when the aggregate supply is greater than aggregate demand, that means supply factor is greater than the demand factor. That means in this excess supply exists in the market, and in that situation demand is less, suppliers are supplying more in the economy, accordingly deflationary gap exists, and due to that deflation exists in the economy, where the stocks are more, supply is more in the economy, and there is very less demand in the economy. Why less demand is there? The reason can be the lack of income factor. And why lack of income factor? Due to unemployment rate is more, right? So, coming to the third, that means theory related to correction of disequilibrium in the economy. Firstly, we have studied equilibrium, that means AD equals to AS. Second, we have studied disequilibrium, that means AD is not equals to AS. That means two situations can be there, AD greater than AS and AD less than AS is there. Right, that means two disequilibrium situations are there. But we have to rectify that situation as well to again get into the position of equilibrium. And for that, corrective measures are taken, and two corrective measures are there. One is the monetary measure, other is the fiscal measure. And who undertakes monetary measure? The Central Bank of India, that is the Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India uses certain instruments through which they correct the disequilibrium in the economy. And second point is fiscal measure. fiscal measure, that means this measure is undertaken by the Government of India, right? The central authority of our economy, that is Government of India, take initiative to correct the disequilibrium in the economy through their budgetary policy, right? So this was all about the economics, the meaning of economics, the types of economics, micro and macroeconomics. Hopefully, every point is clear to you all. Thank you.